गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. आज यस्टरडे वी हैव डन एक्सरसाइज ए बी एंड सी फ्रॉम अ वर्क बुक, इंग्लिश लिटरेचर वर्क बुक ऑफ चैप्टर 1 नानीज वॉक टू द पार्क. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द एक्सरसाइजेस इन वर्क बुक ओनली. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द डी एंड ई एक्सरसाइज. इन द डी एक्सरसाइज वॉट वी हैव टू डू इज वी हैव बीन गिवन द जेंडर्स. As I have already explained you that there are two types of gender, masculine gender and the feminine gender. Masculine gender is for males and the feminine gender is for females. We have been given one of the gender over here like father. You have to write the opposite. Father is the masculine gender. So you have to write the feminine gender of father. And like we have given in the second one, we have been given lioness is the feminine one. In the feminine one you have to write the masculine gender. Like this you have to do fill in the blanks in the D exercise. In the E exercise you have to do countable and uncountable nouns. Countable nouns are those nouns that can be counted, the quantity of which can be counted, and uncountable are those that which cannot be counted, which we cannot add, like milk we cannot add, sugar we cannot add, rice we cannot add, all this we cannot add. So these are uncountable nouns. You have to do E exercise on this one. Now let us begin with the exercises from our workbook on page number 6 and 7. Exercise D and E are on page number 6 and 7. So open to page number 6 in your workbook. You have to do the work in your workbook only. Don't write anything in your notebooks. Let us begin. Now, today we are going to continue with the exercises in workbook only. Now open to page number 6 in your workbooks. And today, as yesterday we have done about the gender round, that is, I have told you there are two genders. First one is the masculine gender and the other one is the feminine gender. D1 is identify gender nouns in the given sentences and underline them. You have to identify the given nouns and underline it. Fill in the blanks with the opposite of the underlined gender nouns. One has been done for you. First one is Akhil's mother is a doctor. Mother is the feminine noun and father is the masculine noun. So his father is a professor, like this. Second one, the tiger is the masculine noun and in the sick dash played with her cups. So tiger and the tigress. Tigress will be the feminine noun. Third one is there are many bulls and dash in the field, bulls and cows. The opposite female of bulls is cows. Let us move to fourth one. Fourth one is the witch and the dash looked funny in their hats. So the masculine of witch is wizard. You have to write, when we have been given the female noun, you have to write the masculine one. If you have been given the masculine one, then you have to write the female one. Now let us move to fifth one. Fifth one is my nephew held my dash carry the heavy bag. The female of nephew is niece. So write niece in the blank being given over here. Sixth one, the king gifted the dash a diamond necklace. The female of king is queen. So write queen in the blank over here. Seventh one is all the girls and the dash were asked to sing together. The masculine of girls is boys. So write boys in the blank. Tanmay played the role of the Duke of Wellington and Tarni played the dash of Wellington. You have to write the female of Duke. So the female of Duke is Duchess. Right? Duchess over here. Duchess. The female of Duke is Duchess. So you have to write the word Duchess over here. I hope you all have got how you have to do the T exercise. Now let us move to the E1. In the E1, countable and uncountable noun. Countable noun are those that can be counted, and uncountable are those that cannot be counted. So nouns that can be counted are called countable nouns. Like a bouquet of flowers, we can count. In a bouquet of flowers, we can count the number of flowers. Four boys, we have already counted. The number of boys are four over here. And seven apples. The number of apples are seven. So we have already counted and written it over here. Nouns that can be counted are countable nouns, and nouns that cannot be counted are uncountable nouns. Nouns that cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns. We use the words like some, much, a little for uncountable noun. Like when we use some, much, little, we use like words like this to uncountable. Some money, we have some money. Much time, we have enough time to do this. Little milk means small quantity of milk. So milk cannot be counted, time cannot be counted, money cannot be counted. So like this you have to, in the E1, make sentences using the given countable and the uncountable noun. You have to make sentences. We have been given the words over here. You have to make sentences with uncountable and countable nouns in the use and make the sentence. Now first one is flowers. So we can make sentence like there are many flowers in the garden. Put a full stop at the end. Burgers. I'm writing, I ate 2 burgers today, and put a full stop at the end. Now let us move to third one. Third one is milk. I drink a glass of milk every day. Put a full stop at the end. Chocolate. Children usually love to eat chocolates. Full stop at the end. Cricket bats. My mother gifted my brother cricket bats on his birthday. The full stop at the end. Smoke fuels. Sorry. Fuels release a lot of smoke while burning. Full stop at the end. Laptops.
laptops are portable and can be carried easily from one place to another.
We have completed with the sentence with the D and E exercise today. Now, today we complete with this chapter 1 in our workbooks. Homework for you all is to, you have to learn D and E exercise today thoroughly. Thank you.